A two-on-one for Ottawa here. DiDomenico has Hoffman with him, plays it to Hoffman, who scores! Mike Hoffman opens the scoring, and the Senators, 8 minutes in, have got the lead.
And Zach Lewin, I was just talking about moments ago. They wait for their opportunity, and this is one heck of a play by DiDomenico to Mike Hoffman. For his fourth goal, opens the scoring. The Senators lead 1-0. We're going to watch right here. Devils get caught in the Ottawa zone. It's an outnumbered situation. Look how he shields the puck. DiDomenico is Adam Henrique's on him, and he doesn't panic with the puck. Head up all the way, able to find Hoffman, and he's able to deposit it in the all open net right there.
Able to pick up the dangerous Carlson. Floats it back. Johnny Aduya drive. He scored! Johnny Aduya back in the rock. Gives the Senators a 2-0 lead.
This is a rocket. Seeing eye shot from Johnny Aduya. And it starts in the Ottawa zone. Devils having a few things go wrong. Severson on the one-timer. Devils were going to get a chance. Broke his stick. And who else? Erik Karlsson joins the attack, goes all the way down to the Devils' corner, and he's able to find Johnny Aduya. Look at the saucer pass right on the tape. He's got time, and through a screen.
Now Stone on the puck once again. Works it away from Heischer. Dion Phaneuf with a shot, blocked by Andy Green, but a stoppage in play in the Devils' zone. And one of the officials might be injured here.
I hate to see this, and it's unfortunate for the Devils as Jesper Bratt was going to have a breakaway. But they recognized, oh, this is just a bad break for the Devils.
It's Brad Meyer is the referee.
Right there, Taylor, he took the high stick, and like I said, this is too bad for New Jersey. Phaneuf shot is blocked by Andy Green in front. There he takes Mark Stone's stick right under the shield.
Puck for New Jersey. He's checked by Thompson. Works it free. Shot! Score! Gibbons! The quick release from Brian Gibbons. Devils have the lead for the first time tonight.
Brian Gibbons continues to get it done for the Devils, whether it's the penalty kill. And this time it's his fourth goal of the year. 5-on-5. Great work. Pavel Zacha's going to get his second assist of the night. As he twists and turns, shields the puck. And look at that backhand pass to Brian Gibbons. Terrific job. Jimmy Hayes as well uses his big frame to shield and pick some Senators.
Dion Phaneuf again, plays it across. Quick shot. They score. DiDomenico at the doorstep was there. Furious rally by the Senators to make this a one-goal game with 1:15 to go. Might have been Mark Stone who finished this off.
He batted out of midair, and I'll tell you, that puck was awfully close to being offside. He waves it off. Let's take a look right here. I don't know if not, he did a terrific job. I didn't see from there because it was out of angle, but they just stayed with it. Look at that puck just tipped in as Kincaid makes a save. It bounces behind him. And hold on to your hat, Ottawa's got life. Look at Stone, wait for that thing to drop.
Andy Green sees Broussard on the puck. Centering try. They score! With 36 seconds to go, Derek Broussard and the Senators tie the game.
Wow, what a change of fortune here with the goaltender pulled twice. And it's DiDomenico on a terrific feed from behind the net. And all of a sudden, the Ottawa Senators have tied this game at 4. They keep it alive, get it down low, Stone. And then there's Derek Broussard right here. Recognize DiDomenico, and he's able to bank that off Keith Kincaid's short side. And we're tied at 4.
2-on-1. Williams delays. Fancy move, what a goal! Jeff Skinner with the finish. What a setup by Justin Williams. That's hockey, baby. We're tied at 1.
Welcome back to North Carolina, Justin Williams. Forces the turnover on Steen and then becomes David Copperfield. Houdini, all wrapped up in one. I mean, I know his empty netter that ensured the Stanley Cup back in 2006 was a very memorable goal. But in terms of the highlight reel dimension, wow.
That loss in overtime as Bobrovsky makes the stop. Rebound scores. It's swept in behind Bobrovsky, who thought he had the puck left in the blue paint. And that one's similar to a goal that Matt Calvert scored here against Buffalo on Wednesday.
Well, one talk out of the Jets camp is scoring from their depth lines, and this is their third line on the ice. And Jack Johnson with that turnover. Sergei makes the save. Then you see his head kind of looking around. He's wondering where the puck is, looking for a rebound. Here's the shot off that turnover. Jack Johnson put it right on the tape. And then Tanev.
Shifley. Wheeler behind. Oh, what a stop! Sergei Bobrovsky, the save of the night! Wheeler behind the defense and flashing the leather with a glove stop with Sergei Bobrovsky. Wow!
While the Blue Jackets bench yelling, screaming at Panarin, hey, Wheeler's behind you. And they finally get in the puck, pulls it to the forehand, but Sergei Bobrovsky challenges and scoops that up in the glove. What a save.
2:58 left. Jackets, Anderson picks it back up. A golden opportunity. Anderson in the slot. Scores! In overtime! He missed the first time, not the second. Jackets win.
He's just going to stay with it. He started this with that forecheck. He's going to go around the horn here and go back against the grain. And that is your Big Lots big play.
Mason unable to recover his goal stick.
Away they go. Could be a 3-on-1. Gaudreau in tight. Shoot. Scores! Well, he let that one go. Johnny Gaudreau makes it 1-0 Calgary.
And you know what, Rick? What a response by Michael Ferland. You get sort of sacked for one shift, if you will. A quick little message and a lucky little breakout pass by Mike Smith. It just shows you how good of his puck playing ability is, how confident he is. But a good shift there through the neutral zone by Michael Ferland to make this play continue with speed through the neutral zone. No one has to wait for the puck and shoot it. Rich and Eric talked about it in the intermission. Shoot the puck, and Johnny Gaudreau elects to do that here. And a beautiful goal. And watch some of the skill displayed by Johnny Gaudreau pre-game in the warm-up, just kind of, you know, feeling the puck on his stick, throwing it up in the air. Mark Jankowski was doing some of the same, and then we spotted him earlier today. He was working on some of his footwork there. Actually, that is Maddox DePasquale, who is Mark DePasquale, the trainer's young son, and having a lot of fun. But you have to say something about Johnny Gaudreau. He has been good on the road.
Quickly across the shore, slap pass, Radulov scores! Another power play goal. And the Dallas Stars take their first lead of the game with 7:10 to go in the third.
The Flames had their opportunity to score on the power play earlier in this period and were unable to really sustain anything. Just to add salt to the wound, the Dallas Stars come back on their opportunity and they make them pay. And just watch this movement up top. This is the difference right here. They spread the width of the ice. That opens up this pass over to Alex Radulov, who had a power play goal last night in Edmonton. And another one here as he starts to catch some fire for the Dallas Stars.
It's always a dangerous pass, but it sometimes surprises the opposition because you don't expect it to come up the middle. It's normally an easy breakup, but this pass misses Nick Schmaltz. It's about 3 feet in front of him. It goes right to Yarncroak. And Yarncroak with the snapshot. So it goes right through.
Crosses over, saved by Rene. Rebound cleared, and the net knocked off the pegs.
and Kane went flying into Rene. They're still on top of each other. Kane is lying top of Pekka Rene across the goal line. What is the call?
Well, we're going to have a penalty here for sure. I don't know if it was if he was pushed in, but he went flying into Pekka. Just bulldozed him. Pekka was down and just got absolutely crushed.
Taves made a great initial move, weaved through a couple of defenders, got that first shot, started that whole scramble, and then look at Patrick Kane's got a little bed head or helmet head coming out of there. Look at that. Look at that lettuce.
He's got a Halloween wig on already.
Puck up ice, ranted in, and a big hit, McNabb. Wow. He laid out perfect. It's the second game in a row McNabb has delivered a big hit. He wiped out Schmaltz against Chicago a couple of nights ago, and that time Kerfoot caught with his head down.
Well, McKinnon's going to come in after, but it is Kerfoot coming up the wall right as he's putting this puck into the Golden Knights zone. McNabb follows through, and he had a hard hit against the Blackhawks and follows up with another one.
Well, the big hit, McNabb on Kerfoot at center ice. To the bench, and now Will saw the Jackets coming quickly. Ooh, open ice hit there. Matt Hendricks on Dubinsky, moving in Dano, and he ripped it wide. And Hendricks getting caught up by a couple of the Blue Jackets after the hit on Dubinsky. Supply to the Jackets centerman.
Yeah, he's reaching for the puck there. Keeping it alive, and Hendricks just his eyes got as big as saucers. You got a guy out of position like that.
Here's Matt Duchene, walks in a couple of steps, feeds it down low. Soderberg, a backhand save dance, and the rebound cleared up, but not out by Carlson. Barry to keep it in. Now here's Duchene with a wrist shot, blocked and hit his own man down low. Second chance and a save dance.
Couple of big saves. As Soderberg, a hard play here right off the line, takes it to the net with a backhand, then gets a chance off the rebound. And Dance able to get that right pad out in time. So Oscar Dance tested in the second period, and he's able to answer strong for the Golden Knights.
AJ Greer now with a steal. Here's Perron. He's got a breakaway. David Perron to the net. A backhand and it scores! David Perron in the clear on the breakaway. Makes it 1-0 Golden Knights.
One thing to get a breakaway, but how about the finish by David Perron? Upstairs to the backhand as he dances Varlamov. And the Golden Knights open up the scoring. Just inside the Golden Knights zone, tries to go D to D. Perron reads it, steals, and a fantastic finish. Little move into the backhand upstairs as the
arm of Puig.
Lindberg trying to break, has it now into the offensive end, and it scores! Oscar Lindberg stays with it and puts it in to make it 2-0.
Second, third effort here as Oscar Lindberg stays with it and finds a way to beat Varlamov as he grabs a shorthanded goal. Oscar Lindberg, here's the battle for the puck. Too many guys, and he's going to find a way to pursue this puck, and then he chips it past Varlamov. He has Andrew Ghetto all over him, then strips the puck from Bigra and puts it over the left shoulder right as the penalty ended. This will be an even strength goal